Hello, hello, hello. Hope you can hear me. Praise God. Hallelujah. We're going to get set up. I'm doing things a little bit different today. My goodness. Let me go ahead and tune my strings up. Let's see here. Let me get closer to this microphone. Sometimes that can be a hard thing to do. Let's get tuned up today. Guitar tuner cost about $10. Praise God. Put it over here. My goodness. Let's see how she sounds. Set up where I can do a live Facebook debate. So if you want to speak your mind on this Facebook live video, you can. Because see, today, the reason why I am in this position is because it's going to be a longer video. And usually I'm standing up playing, but today, since it's going to be a longer video, and I'm going to speak about some false teachers that are amongst us and that are coming up through the satanic ranks, see? And you've got to understand that. You know, God gave us all the ability to read and write. And most of us have that ability to read and write. There's a few that don't, that are illiterate, that they was born with birth defects. But most every American can read and write in their own language. And, you know, in the Bible, it's very important that you learn how to read it for yourself and understand it. Because the minute that you let a man stand up and be the middleman between you and God, what happens is you open yourself up for satanic doctrines. So you open yourself up to be manipulated, because man is always prone to corruption. And, you know, and you've got to understand that particular teacher that you're listening to learned that stuff from somewhere. You know, many of them, what happens is they go to a seminary school and they get a degree. And I heard one preacher stand up, and he's just going through a big thing on the news media and everything like that. And he was talking about how he got a degree through the Church of God denomination. And he came to a question, and this is what he said. He came to a question, and he knew it wasn't the right answer, but underneath pressure, he had to put down the seminary degree people's answer. So, and he called his mentor, and his mentor told him just to answer the question the way the seminary degree wants you to answer it. And in his spirit, God was checking him, and he knew it was wrong. See, so many times what happens is these groups that are on every corner, you know what I mean, I can name them left and right. You know, I really don't want to pick on none of them. But because I understand being mighty and least in the kingdom. But what happens is they get their doctrine from man. And what happens is they manipulate the word of God. And they do this so the board and big wheels will cut them a check. See? So you've got to understand that. And what happens is it spreads like a virus. And you've got to ask yourself, is this doctrines of men or is it doctrines of devils? And, you know, the Bible says we'll know them by their fruits, see? So I don't understand how people can set up there. And I know they went to school. And I know school manipulates things nowadays in this latter time. But, you know, if I was in school and, you know, they want you to spell the word cat, we know it's C-A-T, you know. It's not K-A-T, you know, it's C-A-T, you know. So, and we know the definition of a cat, you know. So anyway, and what happens is, we get people that totally, completely manipulate the word of God, and they take the scriptures out of context, and they just completely misguide you and mislead you. And they separate in their little groups, you know. And it's amazing to me to watch somebody stand up and say things and see a lot of the world on them, you know. And you've got to be careful. You've got to be very, very careful what you do. So with that being said, we're all tuned up. Let me take a minute and let's talk about something here. Now, if you was, you've got to understand not everybody that gets up here on Facebook and YouTube and all that kind of stuff is anointed. You know, anybody can grab a microphone. Anybody can sit behind here and speak. And you've got to discern in the spirit. But if you're not spiritual, you're not going to discern, you know. So if you just Google the word anointing in King James Version, and you was just to take your cell phone and you was just to Google anointing, and we need to find out just what is the definitions, and I'm gonna look at Bible verses about anointing. See, now here it is, 1 John chapter 2:27, and it says, "But the anointing which you have received of him abideth in you." So who gives you the anointing? God does. See, it comes from somewhere. Understand that, okay? Now, and here's what it's for, okay, in you, and ye need not any man's teach you. So there it is. So if you go into a place, and they're bragging about all their degrees, and I want you to read what the Bible says right here. But the anointing which you have received of him abideth in you. Ye need not any man to teach you, but as the same anointing teacheth you all things, and is truth, and is not a lie, and even as I have taught you, you shall abide in him. Now, see, right there. And see, you've got to understand, so these people that get up here and they start bragging about all their degrees and all their seminary degrees. What does it say? Let's read it again so you get down in your spirit. This is 1 John chapter 2, verse 27. But the anointing which you have received of him abideth in you. So who'd you receive it from? You received it from God, okay? And ye need not that any man teach you. See? So understand what that means. And now, let's not get confused, okay? Because we're not eliminating teachers, preachers, prophets, evangelists, and pastors. We're talking about the leaders. We're talking about the inner circle of God's teachers, the fivefold ministry, okay? There are people out here that need to be taught, but a man of God, what the Bible says, will lead them to God. So I'm trying to get you to understand, when someone gets behind a microphone and they begin to brag about, oh, I got a seminary degree from the Church of God and the Pentecostal Oneness, and, you know, from a man, and they're saying that man anointing them to preach, that's completely a false doctrine. Because, see, the Bible says God anoints his teachers. See, not man. God anoints his teachers. And you need not no man to teach you anything. So, you know, some people ask me, oh, you know, where'd you go to school at to get your seminary degree? And, you know, some people, they say, oh, I don't really agree with what you're saying. Some people say, wow, man, you got some revelation in you. And because it really opens up their ears, you know. So there's groups of wheat and a tare. So, but I'm trying to get you to understand, anointed man of God will not manipulate the word. He will lead you to God, and he will not take the glory for that. See, but a man that has a degree by man, he will want to be put up on a pedestal like the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and he'll be wanting to be able to sit in high places and, you know, all the things that the Bible says Pharisees and Sadducees do. So now, when you become a child of God in the kingdom, okay, when you become part of the kingdom and you're baptized in the Holy Spirit and you're entering into the kingdom, you know, that's what we're in. We're in the kingdom age. We're, you know, a lot of people say dispensation of grace, but the Bible says seek ye first the kingdom, you know. And if you don't know where that's at, excuse me, that's Matthew 6:33, okay? And I only read from the King James, so that's all I read from is King James. I don't change the Bible. And, you know, if you read what the King James says about the kingdom, you know, understand, we're not, a lot of people say dispensation of grace, you know, that's just, they use grace. Grace is, the definition, grace is favor. They use that for license of sin. That's a Baptist doctrine, okay? So, but anyway, here it says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall abide in you, okay? So, if the Bible says seek ye first the kingdom, that automatically tells you we're not in the dispensation of the grace. We're in the kingdom age. And the kingdom age is what we're in now. And you say, what is this kingdom? Well, you know, if you go to Luke chapter 17, okay? If you go to Luke chapter 17, it tells you what the kingdom is. And you got to go on down around, let's see here, verse verse 20, okay? You can start there. And when he was demanded of the Pharisees, when the kingdom of God shall come, and he answered to them and said, the kingdom of God cometh not by observation. Neither shall you say, lo here or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you. So, and you've got to understand what the kingdom is. Because, see, when Christ, when he went up and he said, go abide, and I'm going to send the Holy Spirit to you. When they went up in that upper room, see, that was their connection to the kingdom. See, because through the Spirit, we are connected through God. That and see, there's a reason why the Pharisees, such as this guy that I'm talking about, I tagged up in the post. There's a reason why they take Ephesians, and it's a main perverted, not by faith, not by works, that the mainline denomination starts pervert, even including this guy that I tagged in the post. So if you go to Ephesians chapter 2, and you go to King James Version, that's the only thing I read from, once again. If you go to the King James, and here's what it says, okay? And, you know, I don't change the Bible to fit my view. I change my view to fit the Bible, see? So it says, and we'll go ahead and bypass that, all that Pharisee. They do that because they want to pervert this chapter. And but anyway, now if you go on down, verse 13, and you can start there, and it says, but now in Christ Jesus, okay, ye who sometimes are far off are made nigh by the blood. Okay, so these people that they teach on, you know, on Christ, and they say Christ is God instead of the Son of God, they're actually putting Christ, making him as God, and he's the biological Son of God. See, so they're changing the Bible. That's how come they take John 1:1 and they change it. Because, see, so they're trying to remove the blood. See, why would you try to remove the blood? Because the Bible says if you deny the Son, you have not the Father. So the way to the Father is through the Son. You know, what sets Christ apart from everybody else? There is no being on this face of earth that God didn't make, okay? He made all of us, created us by his hands. But Jesus Christ was not made. He was born. See, and you've got to understand, God took his ability to create through the mating process, and you can say you know how they do it in the hospital, they insert in they put the seed in there. But anyway, with that being said, God took his seed, put it in a woman, and here come the biological Son of God that had the blood, direct line of God the Father. See, so I understand what that's saying. So, but anyway, that's what set Christ apart. Everybody else was made, Christ was born. See, so but anyway, and it says that in Hebrews, and we can get to that in a minute. But anyway, right here it says, for he is our peace who hath made both one. Okay. And had broken down the middle wall partition between us. See, now what is that? What wall did he break down? The wall of manipulation. He broke that wall. See, he broke that wall of confusion. Because, see, what was happening was in those days when the man-made temple still existed, what they would do is they would take bribes and they would pervert the Bible, and they would not have forgiveness the way God wanted them to forgive. See, they was manipulating the word. See, so, but anyway, so if we go on down, having abolished in his flesh the enmity of the law and the commandments contained in the ordinance. Now, what it's talking about here is the priestly garments, everything to do with the temple, and also to the penalties of sin. And it's like if you was to go out and you was to break a man-made law, say you speeding and you got a ticket, and you still have to go pay a fine, they won't waive the fine. And what happens is, through Christ, he waived the fine. All you got to do is just say, I'm guilty, and I'm going to stop speeding. See, it's the same thing. But anyway, so that's what he did away with, the ordinance, the penalties of sin. He waived the penalties, okay? Now, for to make in himself twain one new man, so making peace, okay? And that he might reconcile both unto God in the body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereof, and came and preached peace to you which were far off and to them that were nigh. See, it's for everybody. For through him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. And that's the kingdom, see? Because when you have the Holy Spirit, you're connected to the kingdom. You're part of two worlds. That's one of my songs, Two Worlds. Now, therefore, you are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and the household of God, and are built upon the foundations of the apostles, prophets, Jesus Christ being the chief cornerstone. See, he's the one. He's the high priest. He's the one that holds everything together, in whom all building fitly framed together groweth into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also... in whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. So, I mean, it's very simple. So, when you sit back and you see them pervert the Bible, you've got to understand what they're doing. So, but anyway, now with that being said, so watch out for false teachers. They run around and they deny the word of God and they change the Bible. I ain't got to change the Bible, see? And why would you want to remove the blood, you know? And you sit back and you say, oh, my goodness. And someone taught you about John 1:1 because you didn't read it that way. Someone told you that's what it meant. And that's what these people do. They are told what to say, see, by man, see? So... you've got to discern, and you've got to be careful. And I want to go to let's see here. And you say, oh, you know, this guy don't know what he's talking about. And I'm going to show you Hebrews chapter 1, King James Version. I don't know if some of y'all have ever took the time to read this. And this is an amazing chapter. And you can read it straight as it is. And it tells you exactly who Christ is. See? And this is Hebrews chapter 1, King James Version. God who at sundry times and in divers manner spake in times past unto the fathers by the prophets. And that's very blunt, okay? Now, so understand sundry times means during famine, okay? In divers manners, that means in different ways, dreams, visions, his voice, through events, in times past, and to the fathers by the prophets. So, you know, he spoke in many different ways. Hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son. Now, does that say God has spoken to us by God? Or does it say God has spoken unto us? No, it says by his Son, see? So, you know, if you're going to change that word in John chapter 1:1 to mean Jesus, you got to change it here too. See, they want to do confusion, see? So, whom he hath appointed heir of all things. So, now who is going to be on the throne? Christ, see? And you're going to see that when the new kingdom comes down and the thousand-year the reign, 1,000 years. But anyway, I'm kind of tongue-tied. But anyway, so by whom also he made the worlds. Now notice it says the worlds is plural there, okay? So now understand that's talking about the world we live in. It's talking about the kingdom, the world to come in and the world to come, see? And it's talking about the kingdom, see? But anyway, so now, whom being the brightness of his glory. Now, glory is the same thing as celebration. It's your trophy case, okay? Glory, you receive glory after a big win, okay? Now, and the express image of his persons, okay? And upholding all things by his word of his power. See, there's that right there. It says word. So if you're going to change that word in John 1:1, you got to change it here too. Because everywhere there's word, you got to put Jesus there. See? So, but anyway, so that they just want to cause confusion is what I'm trying to say. And, I wonder if this dude went to first grade, okay? When he made by himself, when he had by himself purged our sins and sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high. Now, I don't say he went and sat down on his throne as the majesty. It says he sat down beside the big guy, see? Now, being made so much better than the angels, and hath he by inherited attained more excellent name than they. Now, for unto which of the angels said he at any time, thou art my son? This day I have begotten thee. Now notice that begotten thee. See, that means, you're the firstborn of God the Father. You're my biological son. See, and again, I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. See, and again, when he bringeth the first begotten into the world, he saith, and let all the angels of God worship him. See? And of the angels, he saith, who maketh his angels spirits and ministers of flame of fire. Now listen to this. But unto the Son, he saith, thy throne, O God, is forever and ever, a scripture of righteousness and a scripture of thy kingdom. See? Now, thou hast loved righteousness and hateth iniquity. Therefore, God, even thou, God, hath anointed thee with oil of gladness above thy fellows. Saying, so how can Jesus be the one that created the universe if it says he was created by our power, God, see? So, but anyway, so you got to watch out for these false teachers and these Pharisees that run around and change the word of God and, everything else. It's really ridiculous. That's said. It's really kind of makes you want to laugh at them because how ignorant they are, But anyway, and of course, they ain't got the backbone to get on here and talk about it. They sit behind their little cell phone and hide like a little sissy, because they know that their false doctrines will be exposed. So. But anyway, but it's okay, the Bible says the people that change the word of God, he will remove their name out of the Lamb's book of life. So let's read, let's see what it says about doctrines of devils. Doctrines of devils, King James Version. And see here, here's what it says. Now the Spirit speaketh especially that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith and give heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And that's what this guy is. He's a teacher of doctrines of devils. He ain't anointed, don't talk in tongues, he don't have the Holy Ghost. He sits in his little group and spreads false teachings. Post, crazy things, And if you go and that Bible verse that I posted there in the heading of this video, and if you go to I'm going to go to, I'm going to go to it real quick. Now, it reads, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Okay, so now he says in his post, can't we just say it like in the beginning was Jesus? See, so he changed that word right there to Jesus, see? But now, in the beginning was the Word. Now, this word was right here, the definition of that word is be, have charge, hold, and use, okay? So, understand, okay? So, it says, in the beginning was the Word. So, God had charge of the Word, see? So, he was holding it, okay? And the definition of word is speech and, you know, words, like I'm speaking now. So, in the beginning was the invention of speech. You know, God gave us the ability to communicate, okay? And the Word was with God. So that means if it was with God, that makes it two, okay? So it don't say in the beginning it was God. It says it was with God, so evidently there's two, okay? So, you know, so it says in the beginning, God had the invention of speech and it was with him. That's what it means, okay? Now, and the Word was God. Now, there's that word was again. See, they're making was is. It means have charge, hold, and use. Okay, that means in the beginning, the Word was with God. And he had charge, hold, use of it. See, that's what it means. Now, and you know, you hear these morons get up here and they pervert the Bible. You know, they teach false doctrines. And it says the same was in the beginning with God. Okay, so what's it talk about? The same. It's talk about the invention. When God created man in the garden and formed him out of the dust of the ground, he put a way to communicate with man in him. See, the invention of words. See, then we speak with right now. That's how come there's so much manipulation going on with the word. You know, it talks about the truth. See. Now it says, all things were made by him, and without him, not anything was made. So, all things were made by him, talking about God, see? All right? In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and darkness comprehended it not. See? So, it's very, very simple. We're talking about words and comprehension. And see, a lot of these people, they just want to comprehend the truth. Comprehension is understanding, see? So, and you know, darkness is corruption, and light is, you know, good, see? So, now, there was a man sent from God whose name was John. Who sent him? God, okay? So, the same came for a witness to bear witness of the light. To bear witness of who? God the Father, okay? That all men through him might believe, okay? He was not the light that was said bear witness to the light. Now, many people think that John's talking about Jesus. No, he's talking about John. He's talking about God still. That was the true light which lighteth up every man that cometh into the world. Okay? So, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. So, we're talking about the great falling away of man is what we're talking about. You know, Israel falling to corruption, Moses having to deliver him out of bondage. We're talking about the falling away of man. He came into his own received him not, see. But as many as received him, he gave the power to become who? Sons of God. Even to them that believe on his name, okay, which were born not of blood nor of flesh, but the will of nor the will of man, but of God. Okay, now, here's where it talks about the creation of man. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Now, that word among there is a different Greek word. It means in. Okay? So the Word was made flesh and dwelt in us. Okay? And we beheld his glory as the only begotten of the Father. Full of grace and truth, John bare witness of him, and crying, saying, this is one whom I spake of. He is the one that cometh after me, perfect before me. Now, before means in front, okay? perfect before me, and he was before me. See? And of his fullness have we all received grace for grace. That means favor for favor. For the law was given to Moses, but grace, favor, and truth came by Jesus Christ. No man hath seen God at any time, you know, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, hath declared him. So, I mean, it's very simple. Now, you can continue reading on. And this is the record of John when the Jews sent the Pharisees and the Levites from Jerusalem, asked him, "Who art thou?" And he confessed, and denied not, but confessed, "I am not the Christ." And they asked him, "What then? Art thou Elijah?" And he saith, "No, I am not. Art thou the prophet?" He answered and said, "No." Then he said, they unto him, "Who art thou, that we may give an answer to them that sent us? And what sayest thou of thyself?" He said, "I am the voice of the one crying in the wilderness, make way the straight of the Lord," and said the prophet Elijah. See, and then it says, and they which were sent were of the Pharisees, and they asked him and said unto him, "Why baptize thou then, if thou not be the Christ, nor Elijah, neither the prophet?" John answered them, saying, "I baptize you with water, but the one standeth among you," that means around, a different Greek word than the other one up there, "in whom you know not, he is coming after me, is perfect before me, whose shoes I'm not worthy to latches." See, so, but anyway, so we're going to stop there. So, you know, these people that take the Bible and pervert it, you know, it's really ridiculous, you know. And I'm trying to read your comment there, buddy. Let me see if I can read it. Well, you know, yeah, and you're taking the Bible, and God said, "Let us make," and I'm responding to this comment. And God said, let us make man in our image. Who do you think us was? And, you know, us, and he said, let us make man in our image. You know, so if you step back and you sit there and say us, you're making us, you're changing the word again. So, you know, but he was to go, and, you know, don't you believe in angels and things like that? Don't you believe in also too? Don't you believe in two floods, you know, like the Bible says during the book of Job? So evidently God created man not only once but twice, because we talk about two floods. So, you know, you said, sit there and say us. You said they don't say me and Jesus, you know. So, but anyway, you're just totally taking the word of God. Now, if you want to get on here and have a discussion about it, we can do that, you know. I believe the option is there on the video. If you want to be a big shot and you want to talk about it, you can join the live feed, you know. Let's see if you're brave enough to get on here and talk about it. Anyway, I don't guess that Miss Dana Lee wants to join the video. They just want to sit back and post comments. You know, I can't stand somebody that wants to sit behind a phone and don't want to talk about it. They just want to push their will upon people. You know, at least I'm going through the scripture. At least I'm, you know, reading it word for word. I ain't got to change things. I ain't got to change parables and make them facts. And, you know, I ain't got to do all that stuff. I don't bend the Bible to my view. I bend my view to fit the Bible. These hypocrites that are full of doctrines of devils like Dana Lee, the one posted the comment there, really something else, you know. But anyway. So with that being said, you know, they ain't got the will to join the video, just like this Corey Madison. You know, what a joke. People not anointed, getting up here preaching, spreading false doctrines and things like that. It's really something else, you know. People get on here and they, you know, they don't sing their own songs. They steal everybody else's. They read off a teleprompter. And they're not anointed and, you know, you gotta really watch them people. But anyway, with that being said, let's play a few songs, okay? Anyway. Praise God. Anyway. A little bit underneath the weather. Let's see what we can do here. My goodness. Definitely got turned up by me. Stay upon me. You know, God has gave me some great gifts, and this is a great gift that he gave me, this amazing song with amazing lyrics. And, you know, I'm very blessed. You know, I see people all the time get on here, and they have guitars. Yeah, they're fancy and everything else, but they have none of their own songs, and they learned how to play according to the people that are before us. But me, I learned from God, and I learned off the lyrics and the songs that God gave me. And, you know, so, you know, to y'all haters, keep hating, because let me tell you something, I'm highly favored and blessed, and I'm a child of God, and I don't have to get on here, and I don't have to copycat anybody else. I don't have to play everybody else's music. I started with the songs that God gave me, and I continue to play only the songs that God gave me. I don't get on here, and even though people say, well, why don't you try playing like Amazing Grace? I don't know. I play the songs that God gives me to play. And, you know, so with that being said, you know, so hate all you want to, because you sit there and you're not anointed. God has never gave you any songs. You sit up there and pervert the Bible like this Cody Madison, you know. You got to change the word of God so you fit in your little group, so you have followers, you know. But me, I'm not trying to be popular. I'm just trying to be obedient. So, that being said, you know, God is good. God is very good. I don't know. I should have. Well, we don't have to. We'll go ahead and play this song right here. This right here is a good song. I'm going to play one more, then we'll talk a little bit. But I like this song right here. I'm going to turn it down a little bit. Hallelujah. My goodness. This is a newer song that God gave me just a few weeks ago. Not very many people can say that at all. They get up here and they do other things, have to play a bells and stuff because they're not anointed, see? Thank you. because I don't have to sit up here and I don't have to play everybody else's stuff. I don't have to copycat everybody else's music. I don't have to read off a teleprompter. I don't have to copycat other people's doctrines, such as a Baptist, a Methodist, Church of God, Assembly of God, Pentecost. I don't copycat their stuff. See, when you're anointed, God gives you what things what to say. He breaks down the scriptures to you. He teaches you so you can teach others to lead them to God through Christ Jesus. See, so I'm not a follower. I'm a leader, see. And I lead you straight to God. God be the glory. See, so, you know, with that being said, you know, see, I just love the sound right here. See, me and God got on here, and we did some, made some amazing tunes. See how fat that sounds? Not the rock and roll, but see how good it sounds. See, that sounds amazing. Heavenly sound, you know. My goodness, praise God. Hallelujah. Play one more real quick.
Without you, only the one.
God gave me that song. I don't have to get up here and copycat people, and I don't have to do everybody else's strumming patterns. See, God gave me my own. See, I'm blessed. See, God gave me that strumming pattern. I ain't copycat off nobody else. I didn't put other people's strumming patterns together and make my own and say I did that. No, God gave it to me. See, so that's what I'm trying to tell you. See, these people, they get on here, and they're not anointed. And they get up here, and they just copycat people's stuff. And they do everybody else's songs, and, you know, you know, why won't you start seeking God, and he'll anoint you. He'll give you things to say, and he'll give you things to play, you know. So, but anyway, with that being said, we'll get on here later on, maybe this evening, and do another part to this. Do a little bit different. We'll play some more songs for y'all. I've got one that I wanted to play, one of the very first songs that God gave me. I might play it tonight, but anyway, thank y'all for watching, and maybe one of y'all people that are full of false doctrines will want to get on here and have a Facebook Live debate tonight. You can personal message me. I set it up where I can accept invites, and we can talk about it, okay? So thank you. Have a blessed day.